Okay, this is going to be the second video about equations with two variables, tables of values, and graphs. So looking back at what we did in the first video, we started with a simple equation, x plus y equals 5. And we realized that there are a number of solutions to this equation. In other words, we could make a table of values and say when x is 2, y equals 3, and when x is 1, y equals 4, and so on. And for each of these pairs of numbers, we could plug those numbers into the equation, and the equation would balance. And so we say that these pairs of numbers, x equals 2, y equals 3, satisfies the original equation. Then we went on to a slightly harder equation. We had something like this, 4x minus 2y equals 6. And to make it easier to work with, we isolated the y. In other words, we solved the equation for y, and we said y equals 2x minus 3. And then once again, we made a table of values. We called the first column x, the second column was y, but we were also able to call it 2x minus 3. Since y equals 2x minus 3. And once again, we had pairs of numbers. And each of those pairs was a solution to the original problem. We can check that it's a solution, as we did over here. In other words, checking that x equals negative 2 and y equals negative 7 is a solution to the problem, or satisfies the equation. We plugged those numbers in, we found out that the equation balanced, and so we could say that these two numbers, x equals negative 2 and y equals negative 7, satisfy the equation. So now we can go on to looking at graphs. Here's that equation again. Here's the version of it where I've solved for y. Here's my table of values. Let's see if I can fix that. Okay, and I want to graph this. Now the problem is that we're used to graphs that are just lines. In other words, if I had the problem x plus 3 equals 8, I'd subtract 3 from both sides. I think I'm going to get a different pen. I'd subtract 3 from both sides, and I'd get x equals 5. And then I could just do a simple graph, a number line graph, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I could call this graph, this number line x, and say this point here is where x equals 5. Now the problem is that I've got x's and y's, and I don't want to put the x's and y's on the same line. That's really going to confuse things. So what I'm going to do is draw a second line. I'll draw another line over here, and I'll call this my y line or y axis, and this will have numbers on it too. And what I've done is I've got a much nicer version of it that I made with a ruler. Okay, so here we have the equation. Here we have the table of values that I got from the equation. And here I've got an x number line, or an x axis, and a y number line, or a y axis. And I've put some of the numbers in. Each of these marks where I've put in a number is called a tick mark. That shows that one unit on this graph on the x-axis equals 1, so this is 1, 2, 3, and I can keep counting. And I can also number my y-axis, 1, 2, 3, and put negative numbers in as well. And now I can take these numbers and find out where they are on this graph. So let's start with the negative 2 and the negative 7. So this column here is the x column, and that tells me x is negative 2. Okay, so x is negative 2. And this column and the y column tells me that y is negative 7. So let's see, negative 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. This would be negative 7. And now what I'm going to do is I'm going to look up and down from my x number. In this case, I'm going to go down. And I'm going to go left and right from my y number until I find a place where these two lines meet. And this place is going to be the spot where x is negative 2 and y is negative 7. And I can label that spot. I'm going to label with, let me make some room, parentheses, negative 2, comma, negative 7. This is called an ordered pair. When I want to show a point on a graph, I use an ordered pair. It's an ordered pair because the numbers have to be in order. The first number is going to be the x number, and the second number is the y number. So my ordered pair for this spot is negative 2, negative 7. Let's look at the other numbers I have here, the other pairs of numbers. So I've got a negative 1 and a negative 5. Well, here's my negative 1. On the y-axis, negative 5, let's see, 1, 2, 3, 4, this would be negative 5. So going down from my 1 and over from my 5, I get this point here. And this point, let's see, I'll label it here, is negative 1, comma, negative 5. Continuing, I've got a 0 and a negative 3. Well, where's my 0? Okay, so if this is my x-axis, and this is 3, 2, 1, 0 is right here. This is 0 for both the x and the y. This point here, by the way, is called the origin, because it's where both of the graphs originate. It's where the numbers start. Okay, so x is 0. That means I'm going up and down on this line. And y is negative 3. So this would be negative 3. So my point right here is x is 0, y is negative 3. There's my ordered pair of numbers that shows me what this point is. Looking at the 1 and the negative 1, well, that looks like it should be right about here. 1, negative 1. And the 2 and the 1, so there's 2. 1 is up here. 2 and 1. Now, I could keep going. I could keep filling in numbers. And realize there's numbers in between these numbers. I could have a negative 1.5. I could have a 1/2, a 1.5. I could have smaller fractions, I could have decimals. The nice thing about a graph like this is that once I've started putting in the dots, if I connect all the dots with a ruler, let's connect all the dots with the ruler. What I get is a straight line that goes through all of my dots. And now the really nice thing is every point on this line, not just the dots, but every place on this line would stand for an ordered pair. And each of those ordered pairs is going to be a solution to the original equation. What was that? 4x minus 2y equals 6. In other words, if I figure out what this point is right there, I can take the ordered pair for that point. The first number would be the x, the second number would be the y, plug them into my original equation, and it would satisfy the equation. Okay, that's all the time I have for this video. I'll probably follow it up with another one. That's it. See you next time.